And the Lord loves the things that we do, but there are also things that we do that He hates. We'll study the book of Malachi. And we will learn from the good things and the bad things that the people did during that time. After the Babylonian captivity, the people were allowed to return to Jerusalem and the temple was rebuilt, but the quality of people's worship had gone to shamefully low levels. Siguro dahil sa effect ng Babylonian captivity and because of the people's attempt at reorganizing their personal lives, na prioritize nila yung mga personal na buhay nila, bumaba ang uri ng worship. And God began to hate what the people were doing, even the people's offerings. The people were just going through the motions of worship para lang mairaos, pero hindi para talaga sumamba. Ang ating kayong pag-aaral, offerings that God hates. And we will be taking it from Malachi 1. I want you to bow down your head and pray for someone near you in this hall that the Lord may bless very personally. Pray for someone. Maaaring kilala niyo o hindi, katabi niyo o malayo ng konti. But let the Lord's blessings be real in people's lives. Silently pray for one another. Heavenly Father, we pray for each other that your blessings may be personal, may be real, that you may teach us. That as we gather before you, O God, you may find our hearts willing to worship, willing to be taught, willing to be ruled by you. So we surrender ourselves. Dalangin namin, Panginoon, makapangyari kayo. Turuan niyo kami mula sa mga kasaysayang matagal nang nangyari. Pakita niyo sa amin ang mga katotohanan dito that are universal, that we may learn from, that can teach and modify our behavior. Hinihiling namin, Panginoon, that you may make your words powerful and that you may make our hearts fertile grounds for your words. Speak to us. We are your people. We seek no human voice but yours. Lead us and teach us. Give us very personal applications for the words that we will share today. Lead us, Father. Speak. In Jesus' name, we pray. Offerings that God hates. Meron bang mga ganon? Mga offerings na kinakamuhian ng Diyos. Malachi is a very interesting book. It was written by what many people consider to be the prophet called Malachi. That was his name, or that was the title. That was the title that was used on the writer of this book. After Malachi, God would be silent for many hundreds of years until the silence is broken by John the Baptist. For a long time, for hundreds of years, there would be no revelation, no teaching. So the Lord closes the New Testament with a book where we see a lot of His anger for the people. And God would remain silent for a long time, for centuries, until that silence was broken by the voice of the one crying in the wilderness, John the Baptist. Malachi 1, verses 1 to 5, opens with an oracle. An oracle, the word of the Lord, to Israel through Malachi. I have loved you, says the Lord, but you ask, how have you loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, the Lord say? Yet I have loved Jacob, but Esau I have hated, and have turned his mountains into a wasteland, and left his inheritance to the desert jackals. Edom may say, though we may have been crushed, we will rebuild the ruins. But this is what the Lord Almighty says. They may build, but I will demolish. They will be called the wicked land, a people always under the wrath of the Lord. You will see it with your own eyes and say, great is the Lord, even beyond the borders of Israel. What a terrible way to begin a book, an oracle or a prophecy. That God would see and would show two aspects of his dealings with men. One is of love, and the other one is of hatred. That first, God would establish something very important in bringing home the theme of the book, and that is God's love for his people. There was this very important theme of God's love for his people, that God has loved Israel. He has favored Jacob, Israel's ancestor. Sinasabi niya, hindi ba minahal ko si Jacob, hindi ba mahal ko kayo? Tapos yung mga tao naman, na mga manhid, magtatanong pa, paano nyo naman kami minahal? Parang kulang pa yung pagmamahal ng Diyos sa kanila. And God would say something about Esau. He says, God rejected Esau. God turned Esau's country, Edom, into a desert, that Esau's descendants may defy God's dealings by rebuilding their cities. Sabi na, hindi bale, sirain niya, gagawin uli namin, sirain ng Diyos, gagawin uli namin. Bakit? Hindi ba kami marunong gumawa? They were defying God, but God said that God would tear down whatever the Edomites would build. God would be angry as long as the Edomites were sinful. That's what the Bible says. That God was angry with this line, with this bloodline, because their ancestor and everyone was sinful. And as long as they were sinful and not repentant, God would remain angry. So ang ginagawa nila, imbes silang lumapit sa Diyos, imbes silang magsisi, imbes silang magbago, sinasabi na lang nila, we will rely on ourselves. Whatever God destroys, we will rebuild again, and we will rebuild again, and we will rebuild again. And God said, keep on building, and I will keep on tearing down what you build. Even now, this happens. God who loves also hates. He hates sin. God who loves righteousness hates unrighteousness. You cannot love without hating, because you've got to hate the opposite of the one you love. And so God is angry at sin and is angry at all kinds of unfaithfulness and all kinds of filth. So God was saying in the first opening lines of Malachi that he would assert, that God would assert his omnipotence, his majesty, his reputation, his honor, and his glory. That God would assert his glory despite the Edomites' defiance. This was the opening, but then God would go to the main theme of what he wanted to say. In-establish lang niya kung sino siya. Marunong siyang umibig, marunong siyang magalit, marunong siyang magbigay ng gantimpala, at marunong din siyang magparusa. To establish a more important message, because God, in this book, was displeased. We see here a God who is terribly displeased. So let's take a look at God's hatred for the people's offerings. God hated something that the people were giving him. That would be Malachi 1, 6, and so on. A son honors his father and a servant his master. If I am a father, where is the honor due to me? If I am a master, where is the respect due me? Says the Lord Almighty. It is you, O priests, who show contempt for my name. Ang ganda nga naman na sinasabi niya, ako ang tatay, binibigyan ng honor. Ang master, binibigyan ng honor. O ako ngayon, tatay niyong lahat, Lord God Almighty, nasan yung honor na binibigyan niyo sa akin? Sabi, at kayo pa, mga leaders ng church, mga priest pa, kayo pa, ang nagpapakita ng pagbaliwala ninyo sa aking pangalan. Ano nga ba ang reklamo ng Diyos dito? But you ask, how have we shown contempt for your name? You place defiled food on my altar. But you ask, how have we defiled you? By saying that the Lord's table is contemptible. When you bring blind animals for sacrifice, is that not wrong? When you sacrifice crippled or diseased animals, is that not wrong? Try offering them to your governor. Would he be pleased with you? Would he accept you? Says the Lord Almighty. Now implore God to be gracious to us. With such offerings from your hands, will he accept you? Says the Lord Almighty. Oh, that the one of you would shut the temple doors so that you would not light useless fires on my altar. I am not pleased with you, says the Lord Almighty, and I will accept no offering from your hands. My name will be great among the nations from the rising to the setting of the sun. In every place, incense and pure offerings will be brought to you my name, because my name will be great among the nations, says the Lord Almighty. But you profane it by saying of the Lord's table, it is defiled, and of its food, it is contemptible. And you say, what a burden, and you sniff at it contemptuously, says the Lord Almighty. When you bring injured, crippled, or diseased animals and offer them as sacrifices, should I accept them from your hands, says the Lord God? Cursed is the cheat who has an acceptable male in his flock and vows to give it, but then sacrifices a blemished animal to the Lord. For I am a great king, says the Lord Almighty, and my name is to be feared among the nations. May the Lord bless us through this very interesting reading. That the Lord shows his anger and his displeasure And what was that about? God was angry about the people's offerings. Dinadala ng mga tao na offering sa temple yung mga hayop na bulag, mga lumpo, mga may sakit, at meron pang nakaw. Sabi, oh, mag-offering na tayo, nakawin na yung hayop na yan. At yun ang dadalin sa offering. Samantala, ang linaw-linaw ng inutos ng Diyos sa Leviticus 22, verses 18 up to 23, speak to Aaron and his sons and to all the Israelites and say to them, if any of you, either an Israelite or an alien living in Israel, presents a gift for a burnt offering to the Lord, either to fulfill a vow or as a freewill offering, you must present a male without defect from the cattle, sheep, or goats in order that it may be accepted on your behalf. Do not bring anything with a defect because it will not be accepted on your behalf. When anyone brings from the herd or flock a fellowship offering to the Lord to fulfill a special vow or a freewill offering, it must be without defect or blemish to be acceptable. Do not offer to the Lord the blind, the injured, or the maimed, or anything with warts or festering or running sores. Do not place any of this on the altar as an offering made to the Lord by fire. You may, however, present as a freewill offering an ox or a sheep that is deformed or stunted, but it will not be accepted in fulfillment of a vow. In other words, napakalinaw ng inuutos ng Diyos. Kung kayo may ipinanata, meron kayo isinumpa, may ipinangako kayo, meron kayong mga dadalin, kailangan walang defect. Eh ang mga tao, anong ginagawa nila, dinadala nila? Nagdadala na sila ng mga bulag, yung mga hayop na ang dami-daming sugat, may mga galis. Pagkatapos, pag nandun na sa altar nila, sabi, kadiri naman yung mga nandyan. Sila ang nagsasabi, they were saying, this food is defiled, walang kwenta, pero sila mismo ang may dala. Sabi ni Lord, hindi nyo ba ako nai-insulto niyan? Ako na King of Heaven and Earth who gives you everything, tapos ang ibibigay nyo, ganyan lang, mga tira-tira, minemenos, tinitipid nyo ang inyong mga offering, yung mga mabebenta ng mahal, ipinemaintain ninyo, o yung kakayo ang kakain, tapos yung ipinapadala nyo sa temple, mga ganito, may mga kutakot-takot ng mga kulugo at mga deformities, tapos kayo mismo ang mandidiri sa sarili nyong dalang offering at pipintasan nyo ang mga offering dito sa aking table. So let's take a look at the offerings. The offerings insulted and embarrassed God. Nasaan yung glory ko? Sabi, this is embarrassing. Para bang ang laki-laki mo ng tao, tapos may magbibigay sa'yo ng piso. Oh, piso? Bakit naman itong binibigay mo sa akin? Anong mabibili nito? Eh, tao lang tayo, tumatanggap sa kapwa-tao. Kumisan, naiinsulto ka, binigay lang sa'yo. Debo mo pa naman, beam po na may sulat in check na good morning. Ito lang. Wala na bang iba? Eh, yung ano pa yung Diyos who is King of Heaven and Earth? Sabi mo, ganito ba ako ka-cheap? Ganito lang binibigay nyo? And yet, the people were cheapening their worship. So, the offerings express contempt of God's altar. Yun lang ang contempt of human court. Malaking bagay na yun. Pwede ka na makulong eh. Yung pang contempt of God's altar. Hindi yata yun biro. Yung offering ng mga tao, it was equal to saying, what's so great about the Lord? Pwede na yan. At alam nyo, yan ang sakit ng mga Kristiyano hanggang ngayon. Yung bang, pwede na ito. Kakanta, hindi memoryahin ang kanta, pwede na yan. Sasayaw, hindi nagpa-practice, pwede na yan. Mag-o-offering, silapu-lapu ang ilalagay sa offering, pwede na yan. Diba? Tapos yung mga tres personas, laging dinadala sa rustans. Tapos yung mga ano-ano, si Bonifacio, pwede na yan sa offering, si Rizal. No? So, pwede na yan. Hanggang ngayon, sakit yan ng mga tao. Sabi ng Diyos, nakaka-insulto kayo ah. Ano ako, Diyos ang barya-barya? Diyos ng ganyan-ganyan lamang? People, through their offerings, dishonored God. They dishonored God. Sabi, subukan yung ibigay sa inyong mga gobernador kung tatanggapin niya ang binibigay niyo. At kung makakakuha kayo ng pabor sa mga gobernador niyo dahil yan ang binibigay niyo. Tapos ako, na Diyos na nasa langit, ganyan lang. How can your offering be acceptable to the all-powerful God? So the offering also displeased God. It was a source of terrible agony and displeasure that God was being insulted by the kind of offerings the people were giving Him. So the offerings, because of that, were useless and unacceptable. And to top it all, the offerings were counted as sin. Sabi, akala nyo ba hindi kayo nagkakasala sa offering nyo? Kasalanan yan. I demand the best. I deserve the best. Tapos ganito, kasalanan ang ginagawa nyo. At ano pa po ang nagpalala sa problema ng bayan? The people were complaining. The people considered offering to God a burden. Sabi niya sa verse 13, sabi ni Lord, and you say, what a burden! And you sniff at it contemptuously, says the Lord Almighty. Nabibigatan pa kayo ngayon, nagre-reklama pa kayo na nag-offering. Para ngayon din ang mga tao, naku, ang hirap-hirap na ng buhay. Meron pang donasyon, wala bang libre? Ang mga tao, langin na lang gusto, kabig ng kabig. Pagka sa Diyos, hingi ng hingi. Pagka magbibigay na, ang kukunat. Lagi na lang, wala bang libre? Wala bang discount? Puro ganon. Sabi ni Lord, at sasabihin niyo pang, what a burden? Paano kayo nababurden sa binibigay niyo sa Diyos? Eh, lahat naman ang tinatangkilik niyo, galing lang sa Diyos. You were born with nothing, and you will die with nothing. You brought nothing into the world, and you cannot take anything out of the world. Everything that you enjoy now is just a gift from God. So why will it be a burden to give back to Him? Sabi ni Lord, nakaka-insulto kayo. Reklamo kayo ng reklamo. And even now, many people do that. Reklamo ng reklamo. Merong ministry, nagre-reklamo. Merong duty, nagre-reklamo. Ano ba naman dito? Ang hirap-hirap naman dito. Wala na yatang tumutulong sa akin. Mga nanay-nanay na may dalang anak, ano ba naman dito? Saan ba talaga ang anak ko dadala na Sunday school? Reklamo ng reklamo. Pasalamat kayo, may Sunday school lang yung mga anak. Puro na lang kumisa ng mga tao, personal convenience lang nilang iniisip. Meron pang mga nagre-reklamo, Pastor, pagka naman ho nagwa-worship, naaabala ako sa mga dumadating na late, dumadaan pa ho sa likod ko. E di pumunta kayo sa gitna para walang dumadaan na sa likod nyo. Paano? Uupo kayo dyan sa mga dulo. Gusto nyo madaling pumasok, madaling lumabas. E ang dami pang bakante doon sa loob. Pero siyempre, dadaan lang kayo. Alam ka namang lumipad siya patungo doon sa loob. Tapos magre-reklamo kayo pag nadadaanan. Alam nyo ba, ayaw na ayaw ng Diyos ang reklamo. Especially in His temple, especially during worship, yung puro complaint, complaint, complaint. Wala namang air conditioning, wala namang ganito, walang ganyan. Pag magwa-worship na kayo, alisin nyo yung mga complaint because God hates grumbling. Pati ang mga Israelites na nagre-reklamo, pinadala niya ng ahas. Tukayin lahat yung mga reklamador. Minsan, ibig-ibig ko na rin maglagay ng mga ahas dyan sa ilalim na yan. Yung mga turuan ba, yung tinutuka lang yung mga reklamador. Mga tao, puro complaints, puro complaints. So God hated this all. God hated the form of the offerings. Mga defective, God hated the spirit of the offerings. Para lang bang obligado, half-hearted, walang joy, walang pagkukusa. And God hated the complaints behind the offerings. Nabasa niyo naman yung scripture. Hindi ko na kailangan inventohin. Akala natin lagi para ang Diyos ay yung bang cuddly nice grandfather with white hair dito na kahit ano na lang gawin nating mga kapilyuhan, ang pilyo mo naman, ang cute mo. Hindi ganun. Marunong magalit ang Diyos. Marunong siyang ma-offend. At anong nangyayari? What was God's response to the unacceptable offerings? Of course, rejection of the offering and of the people. He rejected them all. Verses 9 and 10. Now implore God to be gracious to us. Yun daw ang prayer ng mga tao. With such offerings from your hands, will He accept you? Says the Lord Almighty. At ang lakas ng loob niyong manalangin. At ang lakas ng loob niyong magdasal at humingi sa Diyos. Sabi, sa palagay niyo ba? Sa ginagawa niyo sa akin, didingin ko mga dasal niyo? Ang kapal niyo. Kulang na lang ganda na sabihin ni Lord. Meron pa kayong sikmura na humingi. Sabi niya, now implore God to be gracious. Sabi, with such offerings from your hands, do you think I will accept you? Oh, that the one of you would shut the temple doors so that you would not light useless fires on my altar. I am not pleased with you, says the Lord Almighty, and I will accept no offering from your hands. Sabi ni Lord, bakit di nyo nalang isara yung temple? Ilak nyo, ikandado nyo, huwag na lang kayong pumasok, huwag na lang kayong maglagay ng apoy para doon ilagay ang offering. Kasi kahit anong gawin nyo, hindi ko na matatanggapin. Nagsasayang kayo ng pagod nyo. Isaran nyo na lang, maglimutan na tayo. Inyo na yung inyo, akin yung akin. Laban kayo doon. Pag sinabi ni Lord yun, o sige, inyo na yung inyo, akin na lang yung akin. Gusto nyo? Sabi nyo, Lord, hindi ba bakas tayo? Siyempre, gusto natin kabakas ang Diyos. And panalo ka kung kabakas mo siya, dami niyang binibigay. Pero bakit yung iba, ayaw nila magbigay. Yung akin-akin, tapos hingi ka ng hingi sa Diyos. Baka gusto mo, sige, hiwalay na lang, kanya-kanya. Ganyan ang nangyayari sa maraming tao, mga kapatid. Ba't natin ito pinag-aaralan? Kasi nagre-repeat pa ito eh. Hanggang ngayon, ang mga tao, reklamador, ang mga tao, hindi magbigay ng best, kung ano na lang, maramairaos na lang, pakitang tao na lang, tapos may reklamo pa. Pero ang lakas ng loob magdasal. Pag nawala ng preno yung sinasakyan, ang lakas ng loob magdasal. Sabi ni Lord, ba't ka nagdadasal? Nag-offering ka ba? Ba't ka humihingi ngayon ng preno? Pagka nagkasakit na at eto na ngayon, inaagaw na ni kamatayan, dasal lang dasal. Sabi ng Diyos, hingi ka ng hingi. May pinatago ka ba? Nasaan ang binigay mo? Withdraw ka ng withdraw? May dineposit ka ba? Actually, this is what the verses are saying. Napaka-polite lang ng language. Pero yun na rin ang laman. So, what was God's response? Rejection. What else? Displeasure. Kumisan nga, aso lang, ayaw mong inisin, baka kakagatin. Amo mong tao, ayaw mong inisin, baka ka-demote. Bakit mo iinisin ang Diyos? Anong laban mo doon? Naiinis siya sa mga walang kwentang offering. At ano pa ang kanyang response? Curse for the cheater and the unfaithful. Cheating ang tawag niya doon. Kasi ang hinihingi naman ng Diyos, kanya rin, galing sa kanya. Sabi sa verse 14, cursed is the cheat who has an unacceptable male in his flock and vows to give it, but then sacrifices a blemished animal to the Lord. For I am a great king, says the Lord Almighty, and my name is to be feared among the nations. Sabi, may sumpa sa mga mandaraya. Yung mga taong nagpapalit ng isip, sinabi na, ay, ang ganda naman itong ipinanganak na aking flock, i-offer ko kay Lord. At nung lumaki, ay, sobra palang maganda, parang sayang. Wala ba tayo diyang medyo may kapansanan? At yun ang ibibigay, pinanghinayangan. Marami mga ganun kumisan. Gagawa ng commitment kay Lord, pagka spiritually high, tapos mamaya, kukubabawa ng mga espiritu, manghihinayang. Hindi tinutupad ang kanilang mga pangako, hindi tinutupad ang kanilang mga pledges, kinakalimutan ng mga sumpa sa Diyos. Nanunumpa lang pagka nasa panganib o may kailangan, pag guminhawa na, kalimutan na, sabi, Lord, joke only. Dahil lumampas na sa peligro. Maraming ganon, paglampas na sa peligro, joke only na lang yung kanilang mga pangako sa Diyos. Nalilimutan. Sa palagay niyo ba, nalilimutan ng Diyos? No. Sabi niya, my name is to be feared among the nations. Huwag kayong makikipagbiruan sa akin sapagkat hindi ako nakikipagbiruan. Parang ganon ang sinasabi ni Lord. So, God's glory, God's faithfulness, and God's love demands the best offerings. Hindi tayo nagbibigay sa Diyos when we are giving the best offering. Tayo'y nagsusukli-sukli lang ng kanyang kabutihan. Nagbabayad-bayad. Hindi kayang bayarang buo, pero nagbabayad-bayad. In the best of what we can do. Kuminsan, mahirap sa mga preacher ituro ang ganitong mga bagay. Nagmumukhang parang self-serving naman yata yan. Baka gusto lang niya mag-fundraising. But this is the Word of God. And you cannot deny the people these wonderful truths. Marami kasing mga tao naghihirap. Maraming tao, hindi nila natatanggap ang blessing. Ang natatanggap pa nila, sumpa. Just because they don't know na ang ginagawa nila, kinakamuhian pala ng Diyos, dapat imulat ang mga tao. Dapat nilang malaman na kadalasan sa ating mga paghihirap, sa ating mga miseries, tayo yung manufacturer. Tayo yung author. Sapagkat kung gusto kang pagpalain ng Diyos, napakahirap ba nun para niya hindi magawa. Pag gusto ng Diyos, walang nakakapigil. Pero pag ayaw ng Diyos, walang nakakapilit. So ang tanong, nasan yung blessing ni Lord? Di ba ang yaman niya? Ba't ang hirap ko? Bakit ako hirap? Bakit ako pagod na pagod? Bakit walang mangyari? Eh, hindi ka bine-bless? Mahirap bang maintindihan yon? Kasi kung gusto kang i-bless, madali sa Diyos yun. Ngayon, kung hindi tayo bine-bless, magtanong-tanong tayo, maramot ba ang Diyos? Hindi naman. Mahirap din ba siya? Hindi naman. Eh bakit? May problema kaya siya? O ako ang may problema? Pero madalas kasi, bihirang-bihira naman sinisisi natin ang ating sarili. Kadalasan sinisisi natin ang iba. Yung sisisihin mo ang economy, sisihin mo ang presidente, sisihin mo kahit Diyos. Pero ang point, kung gusto ng Diyos na padalang ka ng pagpapala, walang makakapigil. So pag wala yung pagpapala, magtanong-tanong ka, Lord, bakit po? So niya, tanong ka pa. Parang hindi mo alam. Di ba? Na ang kurikuripot mo, ang reklamo mo, ang ganyan-ganyan mo sa buhay, hindi mo ko ino-honor. So, why will I honor you? Napaka-importante po, tingnan natin ating sarili. Siguro, meron mga mangilan-ngilan na napaka-godly, napaka-righteous, tapos mahirap pa rin yung nangyayari sa buhay. Baka naman trial, pero paminsan-minsan lang yung trial. Kadalasan, chastisement yan. Pero meron din, na matutuwid naman, pero nahihirapan, kasi dumadaan sila sa panahon ng trial. Pero konti yon, kadalasan, bunga ng ating mga kamalian ang nangyayari sa ating buhay. God is particular. God is interested with what people offer to Him. Not because He needs the offering by itself, but because the offering honors Him or dishonors Him. Matapos mo naman ibigay sa Diyos, dinidistribute din niya, pinapamigay din niya sa iba. Hindi naman para sa Kanya yun eh. Katulad mga offering hinihingi niya para sa temple, para yung temple ma-maintain, para ma-support yung mga teachers, yung mga workers doon, yung mga priests. Hindi naman para sa Kanya eh. Para rin dun sa temple. At yung temple naman, kung well-supported, well-funded, well-cared for, the temple can also care for the people in return. Ganun din, babalik din sa tao. In other words, ibinibigay mo lang doon para rin bumalik sa'yo. So kung gusto mong tipirin yung sarili mo, ditipirin mo yung binibigay mo, din yun din babalik din sa'yo. Sapagkat sa Diyos naman, kung ano yung binibigay mo, yun ang bumabalik sa'yo eh. Kailan pa kaya maiintindihan ng marami yun, how to break out of the poverty cycle is to be generous. Hindi yung mag-iisam niya, dapat uwaes ka, dapat isahan mo yung iba, dapat matalino ka, dapat lansihin mo sila, 1-2-3-hin mo, kasi hirap na hirap ka na, kailangan makakuha ka. Kailan naman lumuwag sa buhay yung mga ganyan? Yung mga lagi nalang nang dandaya, lagi nalang nang uumit, laging nangungupit, lalong gumagawa ng masama. Kailan pa sila lumuwag? Hindi na. Paulit-ulit din naman ang kahirapan. When will people realize that the key in receiving is first in giving? And it is the duty of every spiritual leader or person or teacher to preach it because this is the key to people's well-being. That they must be taught to give and to give well. Hindi para sila hututan o kuhanan, kundi pag meron kang inaalis sa'yo, pinapalitan ng Diyos ng mas maganda agad. So habang paano mapapalitan kung ayaw mong tanggalin sa kamay mo? It is important. God knows how to be angry. God knows how to withhold blessings. Nakita niyo yung opening? Sabi niya, sige, gumawa kayo. Lahat ng ginagawa niyo, sisirain ko rin. Sige, magmatigas kayo. Umasa kayo sa sarili niyo. Gawin niyo nang gawin. Sisirain ko nang sisirain. Hindi magtatagal. Kumisan sa mga buhay natin, parang nararanasan mo yan. Bakit lahat na lang ng ginagawa namin nagigiba? Bakit hindi na lang magtagumpay, hindi na matuloy? Baka may problema. Dapat mag-isip. Baka hindi natutuwa ang Diyos. Baka naiinsulto siya. Baka naman yung dinadala nating offering, pampaluwag lang ng ating stock. Kasi masikip na, o i-offer yan. Ikaw din ang beneficiary in the end. Kunwari ka pa nagbibigay, pero ikaw din yung nagkaroon ng benefit by trying to give. Believers today also make offerings to God. Iba't iba. May material offering, merong hindi material. You offer your time, you offer your talent, you offer your services. And also we make material offerings. We give our tithes, we give our offerings. Ang tanong, are you honoring God? Na-honor ba siya? Are we giving our best? Magsa-Sunday school teacher ka halimbawa, naghahanda ka ba? Nagre-research? Gumagawa ng mga visual aid? Talagang ipinagpe-pray mo yung mga estudyante para best? O para na lang, basta na lang? Tuwing tatawagin ka pa ng principal for meeting, meeting na naman, ano ba yan? Meeting ng meeting? Yung nagre-reklamo. Sabagay, marami naman talagang meeting na kareklareklamo kasi hindi organized. 15-minute meeting lang, nagiging 2 hours kasi hindi organized yung nagli-lead. Di pagka ganun, sabihin nyo, pag nag-meeting naman tayo, let's stick to the topic. Mamaya, recipe na ng maruya ang pinag-uusapan. Hindi yata yan ang ating agenda dapat. Kasi kukunting tao ang marunong magpa-meeting. Pero pagka ipinapatawag ka, o mag-member ka ng choir, may practice, ba't ka nagre-reklamo, nag-member ka ng choir? O Dr. Kate, meron kayong o-operahan, ba't pa kayo nag-aapura? Alam nyo ba na ang kompletong worship, yung pati yung closing prayer and benediction, yung closing song, blessing yun to the people and to honor God. Bakit bigla nyo pinuputol at mawawala na kayo? For convenience. Dahil ayaw nyong masiksik paglabasan. Pasalamat na kayo sa siksikan dyan at wala kayo sa siksikan sa impyerno. Mas mahisikip doon. Ano ba naman yung mga konting mga ganyan? Hindi ba? Kailangan naman nagko-cooperate tayo kasi ang mga tao, kung kanya-kanya na lang yung kagustuhan, personal convenience yun na lang lagi ang uunahin nyo, ano na mangyayari sa church? Kung bawat isa ay Diyos at Diyos-Diyosan, yung gusto niya ang masusunod, ano na mangyayari? Kaya natin laging sinasabi, kung ayaw niyo pong maabala, doon kayo maupo agad sa kalagitnaan. Kaya dumating siya sa kaliwa at sa kanan, di kayo madadaanan dahil nasa gitna kayo. Para ba yung mga sa jeepney sasakay, gusto yung doon sa babaan siya nakalagay, tapos lahat ng dadaan matapakan siya, galit na galit. Eh di lumagay-lagay kayo doon sa loob. Eh hindi, gusto pagbaba niya, madali na. Yung convenience. Everything is a price. If you want to be convenient, it has a price too. But the important thing is that when you worship God, you let go of your selfish agenda. At talagang i-worship natin siya. Italaga niyo yung sarili niyo. Mag-worship ako. I will permit nobody to steal my joy from me. I will permit no one to tempt me to be angry. I will permit no one to take away my fellowship with God. Ipinaglalaban yan eh. Kasi laging inaagaw yan ng mga forces of darkness. Hindi niyo laging isinusurrender kahit kanino na lang. Cheap naman natin nung kahit sino na lang ginalit kayo, nagalit na nga kayo. Sino lang dumaan, nainis na nga kayo. Para tayong walang sariling orbit. Kung saan may magnet, doon tayo didikit. Wala tayong sariling ruta ng buhay. It is important. So believers today, we still make offerings. God is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Make sure that God is not offended with your offerings. Do not present offerings with defects. Kakanta kayo, gandahan nyo. Sasayaw kayo, gandahan nyo. Mag-o-offer kayo, gandahan nyo. Magbibigay kayo sa church ng gamit, huwag naman yung Olivetti makinilya, natungtungan na lang ngayon sa baha. Pinapaluwag nyo lang yata yung bodega nyo, kaya kayo nagbibigay kumisa na eh, no? I mean, ano ba talaga yan? Hindi nyo naman pwede paglihiman ng Diyos. Nagbibigay ba kayo para makatulong o para lumuwag ang buhay nyo? Sa bagay, pwede na rin yung mga Olivetti pag may baha. Pero yun, sabihin, eto ho, para makapag-type kayo, para naman ako nag-bodybuilding nito nung binuhat ko itong makinilya na to. You know what I mean? Na pinapaluwag nyo lang ang sarili. Hindi talaga nagbibigay. Alam nyo ba? Palilinag ba natin ng Diyos? No. Do not give offerings with defects. Kung meron kayong, Pastor, may ipapadala ho akong electric fan sa church? O sige ho. E daig pa ang hapon, baw ng baw. Ano ba namang electric fan ito? Kusang lumilipad, baka tamaan ka, matapyas pa ang ulo mo. Ano ito, donation? Eh, matetanong kami dito. Mag-isip-isip naman kayo. Dahil ang Diyos na o-offend. Hindi ko alam kung bakit ganon, pero ang Diyos, ganon niya kamahal yung church. Kahit pa nga yung church imperfect, kahit pa nga maraming mga kamalian tayo, marami tayong, pero mahal na mahal ni Lord yung church. Ganon na lang ang pag-iingat niya na yung nagiging blessing sa church, binebless niya, pero yung mga ganon, may curse pa. Because the church is the body of Jesus. Wala kayong maiimbentong human association or grouping more sacred than the church. Because the church is the body of Jesus. Sabi niya, this is my body of which I am the head. So yung body na yan, kahit marami tayo kumisang kakulangan, pero mahal yan ng Diyos. Mahalin natin. Pag malasakitan, let's do our best. Let's give our best. Think of what you can do for your church, not always what this church can give to you. Baligtarin naman ang ating mga paradigm nang makatakas tayo dito sa mga poverty, mga difficulty, mga misery. Kasi baka hindi natin alam, ito palang pinagmumulan that God does not like our offerings. Na-o-offend siya. Kumisan, di ba, tayo man tao, may ipinadala sa'yo. Kumisan, nakaka-insulto. Bakit ako pinadala nito? Tulad ng kinukwento ko sa inyong missionary, mag-asawa. Pinadadala sila ng mga damit na gamit na. O sige, pinagtsatsagaan nila, sige. Pero talaga namang lumaglag ang luha nila, minsan tumanggap sila ng mga tea bags na gamit na. I'm talking about real life here. Cha na gamit na, pinatuyo, ipinadala sa missionary. Yung pang ano ba yan? Hindi mo ba iniinsulto yung amo niyan, yung Diyos na nagpadala sa kanya? Ba't kanon lang ibibigay mo? Tayo na lang, yung nag-iisip magpadala, oy, may mga pastor, regaluhan natin, puro mga gamit, puro luma na. Ba't hindi makapag-isip-isip ito, magbigay ng bago-bago? Nakaka-insulto. Mga kawawang tao, bibigyan mo, lagi na lang yung hindi mo na rin kailangan. Ano ba ito, damit o trapo? Hoy, kahit trapo yan, sasabihin niya, YSL yan, pasalamat ka. Eh, trapo na rin. Ano ba yung puso natin, asan? Hindi naman mahirap pag-aralan yung itinuturo ng Bible ng generosity at giving. Paulit-ulit, yun ang tema. Kailan pa tayo tatablan? Na maging totoo, na yung nadidinig natin maging totoo sa buhay natin, hindi lang maging ideya. Do not bring substandard and low quality offerings. And do not complain about your services to God. Magse-serve na rin lang kayo. Sige na. Huwag nang magreklamo. Paulit-ulit sa Bible, kita natin, ang dalawang kinamumuhian ng Diyos, religious hypocrisy at saka yung grumbling. Ayaw na ayaw niya ng grumbling. Siya lang, reklamo, reklamo, reklamo. Always find something to thank God for. Hindi kayo mauubusan. Pero pag you always look for something to complain about, hindi rin kayo mauubusan. But look, kung naghahanap kayo ng nakakasaya, kung naghahanap kayo ng nakakalungkot, di ba kayo din ang lumilikha kung sasaya kayo o lulungkot? Kaya importante. Make sure your offerings are acceptable, that they are the best, and that they are proportionate to God's supply. Proportionate. He has restored Israel from captivity. He also has restored us from captivity, from darkness. God has been so good. Give offerings that God loves. Ano ba yon? Talent, time, treasure. God is looking for offerings because the offerings tell Him that we submit to Him, that we honor Him. Let's bow before the Lord and review the way we deal with Him. Paano ba tayo mag-offer sa Panginoon? Go-offer nga ba tayo o hindi? Are we faithful? Are we giving our best? Yung mga best people in their fields, technicians, teachers, specialists, ang sanlibutan lang ba ang nakikinabang sa binigay sa inyo ng Lord na kakayahan, karunungan, edukasyon? Sinusurrender nyo ba yan sa church? Nagsasabi ba kayong, ako, meron ako alam sa ganitong area, I surrender my talent, and I volunteer my services. Yung mga ibigay sa inyo ni Lord ng mga kakayahan, karunungan, kapangyarihan, ginagamit nyo ba yan to glorify God o pang inyo lang? God who made heaven and earth is expecting offerings. And He likes only the best. Let's be silent before the Lord and let Him be our judge. Kung ano tayo, sino tayo. At nawa, kung merong mga hindi nakakalugod sa Diyos, let the Holy Spirit speak to us now. Mahirap yung galit sa atin ng Diyos. Mahirap yung hindi siya natutuwa sa atin. Hanapin natin ang kanyang kaluguran, ang kanyang kaluwalhatian. We have to change our lifestyle, change our ways. Let's do it. Do not give Him offerings that He hates. Silently, seek the Lord's counsel.